Welcome to Jesse Junction tonight. Now, I want to thank you so much for always subscribing to this great show. I appreciate so much. I've seen most of you have been telling me, Jesse, I'm watching from Bahrain. I appreciate you. Thank you. What, you are Bahrain? I'm watching from Iraq. Thank you so much. And all, of course, I'm getting a lot of messages from people from Australia. Wakisha Amka, they come on Jesse Junction and they continue watching the show. Thank you. What, wangu wa Dallas, Texas, Seattle, Atlanta, Georgia. Niliambiwa inaitwa Atlanta, Georgia. Thank you so much. Washington, D.C. na Oregon. I appreciate watu wote wako United States of America. Watu wa Canada. I appreciate so much. Mnajijua huko kina Kavi mentality. Thank you so much for keeping it. Jesse Junction. I appreciate you so much. Na watu wa UAE. I can't forget you. My lovely people from Doha, Qatar. I love you so much. Dubai, Abu Dhabi. I appreciate. And of course, families of Jesse Junction in the United Kingdom, Nottingham, Scotland, nyinyi wote nawapenda sana. Kina Ndongo wa Calabash pale Scotland, thank you so much. Mmekuwa mkiniambia mnapenda Jesse Junction so much. Nottingham, K Davies wa Nottingham, thank you so much. And London, Deno, and all of you, Mr. Seed from London, I appreciate so much. And all of you from Europe, I can mention all of you, but allow me to continue with the Jesse Junction tonight. Thank you for subscribing. Na watu wangu wote wa hapa nchini Kenya, thank you for keeping it Jesse Junction. I love you so much. Now, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and that is why we are going to do Jesse Junction differently tonight. So I have a guest that is unique, a unique guest. You don't want to miss this story because she has gone through so much, yet she's smiling and happy. And that is why I want you to stick here. Don't go anywhere, because my guest is coming here to talk about breast cancer awareness. And that is why I want to urge you today, don't go. It's a moving story. You want to hear it on Jesse Junction, Breast Cancer Awareness Month of October. The support you're giving to all the women tonight and any other person who might be affected by this disease, the breast cancer. We are with you on Jesse Junction. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with our guest. So ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Yeah. Are they from Kisumu City? Please show your love for one and only Dr. Othuol Othuol.
Those are my names in short if you like. If you don't like, I am a boy handsome, home and away. I am also a result of unprotected sex between Peter Mondi and his girlfriend Anna Lentoy the Maasai. And I'm very sure I'm not alone in the house. So if you do believe that you are a result of unprotected sex, let me hear you say I. The eyes have it.
Welcome to Jesse Junction. Now, the Breast Cancer Awareness Month is marked in all countries across the world every October. It helps to increase attention and support for the awareness, early detection and treatment, as well as palliative care for this disease. According to International Agency for Research and Cancer, GlobalCan 2008, there are about 1.38 million new cases and 458,000 deaths from breast cancer each year. Breast cancer is by far the most common cancer in women worldwide, both in the developed and developing countries. Tonight, we host a lady who is a warrior and more than a conqueror, Jackie Jude. Jackie, actually, what I want people to know is this. When I was giving out on Jesse Junction tickets za kwenda kufanywa spa na massage on Miss White Spa, so I announced it on my Instagram and a lot of people told me, Jesse, nipatie. So there's this lady who actually came on my inbox. Actually, ilienda kwa comments, then on my inbox, akaniambia, Jesse, nataka unipatie your ticket because of 1, 2, 3, 4. Nikaona, wacha nimpeleke. So I went all the way to where she lives in Rongai, Nanika meet, and that's why she's here today. Our winner wa ticket yetu ya Miss White Spa. Ukaenda ukatriti. Ulienda by the way? Miss White.
Yes.
Alafu ilikuwaje?
Beautiful treat. Massage. You can see my hair. My nails.
Ebu mkona. Wewe. Hizi ni za Miss White.
Hizi ni za Miss White.
Na nywele pia.
Na nywele pia.
Katengenezwa.
Katengenezwa. Nikapigwa massage. Kasikia vizuri.
Unakaa poa by the way.
Thank you so much.
Watu wengi wanashangaa. Naona hii. So massage ilikuwaje?
Oh.
Ukando wanayo. Na ukapumzika.
Nikapumzika.
Here you are. So thank you Miss White of Miss White Spa for giving my fans a treat ya kwenda pale. Asante sana. Tunashukuru sana. Tutazidi kukuja. Na hata mimi nikapiti hapo nikapigwa kashave. Nikasikia poa. Mambo have you been?
Poa, I've been fine. Yeah.
You know the last time tulionana, I came to Rongai. And then nikakupea hiyo ticket. Nikakuja, nikaona kadem, kanitua Jackie Jude. Nikakaniambia Jesse nataka hii, nikakupatia hiyo ticket. Then ukaniambia karibu chai. Kunywa tukunywa chai. Nakwambia, nilikuwa nakuletea tu hii, alafu niende. Ukaniambia, I want us to talk. Nikakuja, tukaongea, nikakwambia, why don't we talk on Jesse Junction? Sasa niambie story.
Wow, first and foremost, wacha niseme asante kwa kunihost.
Karibu sana.
It's a big, big honor for me and my family. This is it's a great opportunity for me, basically to do two things. Number one, it is to encourage people out there who are facing challenges and especially who are going through a situation like mine, that is breast cancer or any other type of cancer. And another thing is to advocate for screening, early screening of cancer, kwa sababu most of the people wana ignore kwenda kufanya hizo screening. Na wakikaa, the moment wana realize it is too late. Na ukienda hospitali, when it's too late again, inakuwa complex.
Yes.
So that is actually my aim today, to encourage people out there when you wanapitia challenge, niwaambie, when you truly believe in God, however difficult the situation is, Mungu anakuwa atasimama na wewe. And number two, wacha watu wajitokeze nje, waende wakapimwe. Because this is October, it is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. I think when you walk in any hospital, uambie unataka kufanywa screening, hakuna daktari atakusimamisha. So that is why I really wanted us to sit down and have this talk.
You told me when we met in Rongai, Kanembe, Jesse, I'm a cancer warrior.
Yeah.
And I want us to talk about it on Jesse Junction.
Yeah.
Now tell me about it, because I was like, wow. So she has a story, she needs to tell me. Ukaniambia, you are actually, because I went and tried following up the story on the interview you had with Betty Chalo. That time she was still at K24.
Yes, yes.
Hata sikuona yote, niliona beginning, then ukaniambia, you're on your way, you're coming. Nikasema, well, okay, sawa. Let's talk about it. So when did you yourself go for screening?
Well, I didn't go for screening. What happened is, I got married first in, mimi nilifanya harusi in 2017 December. And before then, it was around, thank you, I'm married.
To Jude now.
To Jude. And,
so that's 3 years.
3 years. This December we are celebrating our third anniversary.
Fantastic. Congratulations in
thank
advance.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
So ulikuwa unaolewa in December?
Mimi nilikuwa naolewa in December of 2017. Actually, on 30th of December, that's my birthday. And this guy tells me, hiyo ndo zawadi nataka nikupatie. I want to marry you on your birthday.
Yes. Na mlikuwa mmedate na yes.
Tuko tumedate for long sana.
Miaka ngapi ama hata ulisahau?
Asisahau, to date around 6 years.
6 years of dating?
Yeah, 6 years of dating.
Hata yeye alikuwa anangoja nini? 6 years. Una date usema 6 years. Si umuoe.
Okay, schooling. Well,
6 months ni enough.
Hapana, I was in school.
Oh, okay.
Nona. So, atungefanya wedding nikiwa shule. Alingoja, paka nikamaliza.
Ulikuwa shule wapi?
I was in the Mount Kenya University.
Hapo ndio mlikutana?
Hapana, tulikutana before niende university.
Wapi?
Meru.
Okay, siongeze.
So tulikutana Meru.
Uh-huh.
And then nilipata niende campus.
Uh-huh.
So tukakubaliana, tukakuwa friends.
Uh-huh.
I didn't know it will end up into marriage.
Uh-huh.
So tukakuwa tu mabeshte. Then tukasukuma tu life as friends, and then one day akaniambia, hey, mazee, kuna vile nakupenda tu.
Uh-huh.
Okay, nikamwambia fine, unajua niko shule. Akaniambia fine.
Sasa hiyo ulikuwa high school?
No, nilikuwa nishamaliza high school.
Yeye pia ni Meru.
Yeah, ni mfaitae
kabisa. Tunanga mchezo, ukipenda ushapenda.
Ushapenda. Yeah. So tukapendana, and then akanipropozia on some point, nikasema yes.
Uh-huh.
And then now we set our wedding to be on. Akaniambia ile siku itakuwa, ile Saturday ita fall on your birthday.
Yes.
Don't tutafanya harusi. Tukangalia kalenda, tukona ina fall on 2017. That is, I think we're back in 2014.
What?
Yes.
Yani 2014?
Tukamarriage
2017. Mwanaume anakuambia, the day your birthday will fall on a Saturday.
Yes.
Hiyo ndiyo siku nitakuwa.
Takuwa.
And it takes 4 years.
Yes.
For that calendar to change. Did you know that?
Yeah.
Aba baba. Hey. Meru akakwambia ile siku.
Ile siku itaingia.
Baba itakuwa Saturday. Itakuwa. Na anakwambia when you know very well iko na Monday. So lazima ende Tuesday hivyo mpaka 2014. Mpaka 2017 sasa.
Yes.
Ehe. Mm.
So 2017 ndo imefika.
Yes. Ukamwambia so, saa tu.
I knew two December. Things were here. Eh. I knew two. Kwa sababu niko nimeangalia nikaona it's falling in December.
Yes.
In 2017.
Uh-huh.
So tukakubaliana. In August, ndo tulienda kwetu for hizo negotiations.
August 2017.
August 2017.
Hey, harusi 2017. December 30th. Na sasa anaanza kufanya rorashi August.
August of that year.
Uh-huh.
So tukaenda kwetu, tukafanya hizo negotiations. So we came back to Nairobi, ndo
yes.
Tuendelee na hizo arrangements za harusi and everything.
Yes.
Tushamalizana na wazazi, and now it's me and him now to
yes.
prepare for a wedding.
Uh-huh.
Wow, Jesse, that was on August. September, ikafika. So, you know, I'm very happy, up and about. I'm getting married. This is my big day. Tao, nikienda every shop kuangalia the best gowns na pitia huko River Road.
Yes.
Naangalia tu. Na
kama mrembo kawaida vile anaendaga kuangalia madam.
Una shop tu, napita
yes.
every shop. That is in September now.
Yes.
Nisha jua, we shall do things.
Sasa amelipa dawari.
And everything.
Kuona hii ni sure bet.
Aish.
Na nikipenzi taroho.
Nikipenzi kabisa.
Eh.
Wa
Meru atunanga mchezo tukipenda tumependa. Eh?
So,
mm-hmm.
That is in September.
Yes.
Around mid September, siku moja nikioga.
Mm-hmm.
Nikasikia alarm kauvimbe tu kwa nyonyo. Wa siku like haikuni hit sana. It was very small thing. And then the following day, nikioga tena, nikasikia bado na I feel, eh? Wa, so now this one, ikaanza kunishtua kidogo. So I called him, nikamwambia we, na by the way, kuna vile nasikia uvimbe kwa matiti,
mm-hmm.
na kuna vile nasikia mtu akikuwa na uvimbe, inaweza kuwa a bad thing, or lazima tu mtu waangaliwe.
Mm-hmm.
So kaniambia mbona usiende hospitali waangaliwe.
Uh-huh.
So, akanipeleka St. Mary's. Langata
sasa.
So tukaenda.
So that time munaishi naye ama kila mtu anaishi
kila mtu anaishi kwake.
Me was just boyfriend and girlfriend.
It's boyfriend and girlfriend. Na tukutaka kuishi pamoja.
Mpaka muoane.
Mpaka tuoane.
Kwa nini mlikuwa mmeokoka?
My friends.
Eh?
Atukutaka kufanya. We didn't want to stay together.
So you wanted the one he kept for me
yes.
to be a reality.
Yes.
Yeah, the one God kept for me.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Nikamwambia aka yes, alikuwa amefungua hardware in Ronga. So hiyo siku akafunga job akanipeleka St. Mary's Langata.
Mm-hmm.
Tukaenda usi, daktari akaniangalia and then I was told we shall do a biopsy. Yes. Biopsy is whereby unakatwa a small piece of the lamb inatestiwa. So unajua ukiambia unaingia theater mazee, hata kama ni kidogo kuna hiyo tension. Akanipea psych tu, akaniambia ingia tu utolewe, si kitu kikubwa. So nikaingia, nikafanywa that small, the minor surgery, nikatolewa that small lump. Nikakatwa, ikatolewa.
But it wasn't that same same day.
It was the same same day,
same
actually.
Day.
Yes, it was the same day, nikatolewa.
So daktari kwa mesema hii?
Hii, vile tunaifeel iko ndani, wacha tuitoe, we can't tell what exactly is, wacha tu. Tutoe to test, ikapelekwa lab. So the doctor said, nitangoja for a whole month. Ndo result itoke.
Yes.
So I waited. So tukaenda home. Do you know, even that whole month, there was nothing that was in my mind. Like me nilikuwa tu freshi, nafikiria tu wedding. Ana sifikiri kuna kitu yuko hospitali.
Yes.
So the doctor told me niende on 16th of October. Ndo nikachukue results. So mimi nimetayarisha everything, nimenunua most of the things za harusi zenye I wanted. And then on 16th of October, ikafika. It was on a Monday, I remember. Jesse, on Sunday 15th, I was actually preaching in my church. But this kukwambia, I'm saved, I'm born again, na Yesu ni mwokozi wa maisha yangu.
Amen. Na wewe una preaching.
Yes, I do preach.
Which church?
Methodist Church.
Yarongai
ya sasa. I was having the first service. We've got two services. Ya kwanza na ya pili. So I was preaching on the first service.
You are an evangelist. Ama ulikuwa na preach as a sister.
Actually, what there was, my boyfriend, was supposed to preach on that day.
He's a pastor.
He's not a pastor, but he's a more of a mentor to youths.
Okay.
So yeah, anapewangwa service, anapreachia youth. Imagine, nilikuwa nina preach and then I was telling people, imagine you're in a situation whereby you're hit to the rock bottom kabisa. What can you do? I was encouraging them, nikuambia, the way unaweza elevate your faith and trusting God more and more and more. No, na? And then I'm asking them, even at that time when you umegongwa kabisa in life, ukona challenge flani, where trust God to cause atakusort in a way. That was on 15th, on Sunday. 16th, ikafika. So, nikambia Jude, ae, mine enda usi kuchukua results. Haka nambia, we enda, ukisha toka usi, come, so that we can plan. Kwa sababu na we need to sit and rearrange kila kitu
yes.
ya arusi. So, kimbia usi, ukamu. Hata haku nipeleka kuchukua results. Because actually, there was nothing that was in our mind.
Sasa umetoka kupreach.
On Sunday.
Tuma tu enda hospitali. There's no other bad report you can get. You are from good news.
Yeah.
Hata mimi ningekwambia
enda urudi. Jesse 16 ikafika. Mimi nikaenda St. Mary's Langata kuchukua resort zangu. Kufika daktari akaniambia okay, you are Jackie. Nikamwambia yes. Unajua vile una cut. Oh, was young then. Nasikuwa mkubwa, was a small kagal tu. Akaniuliza you are Jackie. Nikamwambia yes. Are you sure? Nikamwambia yes. Akaniuliza hizi result unakujia za nani? Nikamwambia ni zangu. How old are you? Nikamwambia niko 25 years old. Nikaona ameshtuka kuniangalia but still siku sense kuna anything wrong. Akaniambia I have the results but let's go to a certain room tuone another daktari atu explain more about these results. Actually, the guy didn't give me the results. Akaniambia, let's go. Mi huwa na simu, alikuwa anaona kama anaweza soma nijue nini kilikuwa. So tukaenda na yeye in another room. So kuingia in that room, nikakaa. And then one doctor akakuja, mwingine akaingia, there were like 4 or 5, I don't even remember. Wote wamekaa. Then mimi nimekaa hapo. Just to do you know, even at that time, hakuna kitu ilikuwa inanihit kwa akili yangu, kuna anything wrong. But I'm wondering, mbona wanaingia watu wote? I just needed maybe one to explain to me what the results ziko. So nikaingia, wakaanza kuniuliza maswali. There was another, a Dr. Meru guy, who knew I was getting married, mwenye alinifanyia the biopsy. Nona, because kwa hivyo alinifanyanga the counseling kidogo before.
Yes.
So this guy knew I was getting married and actually carried a card for the doctor. So wakaanza kunipanga panga kwa akili. Hey, bibi harusi uko aje? Nini nini? Eh, this girl is getting married. Wanani enjoy?
Mm-hmm.
Ndio waone kama maybe kuna kitu ninafikiria. Kwanza kwa mea madaktari, this girl is from Meru, kanaolewa, nini nini, kona harusi, like this. Mina wambia hata daktari ni kona barua kadi yako ya harusi. Noi.
Noi ukuje.
Noi, lazima ukuje kwa harusi yangu. Mina wakaniambia, Jackie, as you can see, sisi wate tumeshtuka, na indo resort yako, na si resort mzuri sana. Kwa sababu, you have cancer. And not only is it cancer, but it's cancer at stage 3. Wow. The world stopped for a moment. So kila mtu akanyamaza. Wanangoja sasa reaction. Nikauliza daktari sasa what will we do? Akaniambia, atuwezi kukuambia saa hii, kwanza who do you live with? Because this is a thing we need to sit down and come up with a plan, your treatment plan. Because atuta kupea dawa saa hii wende nyumbani. It's a thing, utakuja na watu wenye mnaishi na wao, and then tuwaeleze what is to be done. Kwa sababu, if we don't do this early, things are not good. We, Jesse, nilikaka kidogo hivi, after some 3 or 2 minutes ndo ilisinki, nikamuliza, wait a minute, did you say cancer? Projo sasa hiku imenigonga.
Yeah.
Aki Jesse, akiwa mimi niliisha tu completely. Ay, nilibreki kabisa. Then, walinipea tu time nikalia. Kabisa nikalia, wakiwa tu hapo wananipea time. Then after kuabsorb the news, nini nini, nikawauliza, wacha tu niende home. Kaniuliza utaweza kufika home, kambia ye, nitaenda. So we went home. Unaona, ukisha toka St. Mary's, iyo junction, iyo roundabout kwa hapo barracks, sama hapo barracks, enye inaingia hapo, inapanda Rongai hapo kwa cemetery.
Yes.
Nilikuwa nimefikiria, nitaingia hapo, venye magari zina cross hivi, hii nijiweke hapo. Hata sitapelekwa mbali, niweke tu hapo kwa cemetery. Cause no, yani tu, hata uwezi fikiria, cancer, Jesse, at only 25 years, wakati umemaliza shule, your life is at the peak, you've got ambitions, you've got career you want to pursue, and then unambuka na cancer stage 3, mazi Jesse. Mie kwa nataka tu nikongwa, tu nizo magari, tumalizie story hapo. Eh, but again, nikakumbuka jana, I was telling people, that time you're hit, kabisa uko down, utafanya nini? Nikajiuliza, God, are you testing me? Ama ni nini? Jana mindo nilikuwa naambia wase, vile watakuwa na faith, vile wataomba. And then sasa, hata tujaenda mbali, hii ni mandi.
Yeah.
Ndo huyu mimi, sasa nimesha patikana kabisa. Nikajiambia tu, acha tu, ni trust to you God to niende to home. Wakani refer to Kenyatta. To a specific breast surgeon. Big up Dr. Juka is the best breast surgeon.
Mm-hmm.
So tukaenda kwake. Dr. Juka akiniangalia is like, no.
You're helping.
No, go for a repeat. Nikaenda for another repeat. Ika show positive bado. Every doctor mwenye likuwa napelekea hizo papers zangu alikuwa anasema hapana, go for another repeat, go for another option, check with these doctors. I checked with almost 3-4 doctors, ikaturn to positive.
Why were they telling me to do now?
Kuza waamini, no, and me vile niko, any, nobody was believing like neza patakanzi, I don't know, kuza ata mi mwenyewe nilikuwa ina denial, ninaambia daktari, na daktari tunaweza test tena. Na test. Ah, finally, Jesse nikakubali. So it was not easy. Kukubali uko na cancer, Jesse, it's not easy. So what next? Treatment plan. What's treatment plan? Chemotherapy, talk of surgery, you know, talk of radiation, So daktari akaniambia, nikamwambia daktari, mjue vile mnanitreat, niko na harusi, msisahau. Unaona?
Yeah.
Niko na harusi daktari, na it's only a month to the wedding. So unaingia Google, una Google side effect za cancer tu. Unaona vile utakuwa, vile uta lose your hair, nini nini, hizo vitu zote. Na hii kitu ndio unaambiwa ufanye before your wedding. So what was in my mind was, nifanye hiyo treatment, ni lose nywele, I have wedding that is coming. Sasa nitakaaje? Unaona? Before then, just as I told you, I'm a believer. Nilitaka kuuliza God swali. So doctors wakasema, don't push her to into treatment. Mwacheni kwanza absorb, yani akubali yeye mwenyewe. Unaona? Nikaenda home. Kwenda home, daktari walitupea like 3-4 days zangu nikubali ni, na nifikirie vizuri alafu niingie treatment, kwa sababu ukipushiwa into treatment hata haitakusaidia. Unaona? Afadhali tu ukue willing, uende tu hosiwe mwenyewe ufanywe hiyo treatment kuliko kupushiwa into it. Unaona? Alafu si kitu ati useme ni panadol unakunywa. Hii ni chemo, my friend. Unawekwa inakugonga kwa floor kabisa. Nakwambia, I wanted to ask God a question. So, my hubby, wao wakukuwa na shida, send my fiance. Ako tu hapo.
He was still there.
Ako tu na mimi. Anambia,
did you discuss anything to do with the wedding that time?
With him?
Yes. After umeambiwa, this is the situation in which you start chemotherapy. Are you going to discuss about the wedding with him?
Eh.
Ama alikuwa tu amenyamaza?
Tulikuwa tumediscuss. Akaniambia, aki, wacha nikwambie tu, Jess, this is a guy, I don't even have words. Akaniambia, Jackie, nakupenda. With or without cancer, nakupenda. And I'll marry you on this day. Nona, hata kama utakuwa Kenyatta umelazwa, hata kama utakuwa wapi, I'll marry you. And there's nothing that is stopping us from doing the wedding. At least that was therapeutic to me, because this is cancer, unaona. Akaniambia, now let's start treatment together. Tufanye hiki tu sisi wawili. I am with you na nitakusupport kabisa with anything you want. Nikamuuliza, sasa utanioa nikiwa mgonjwa? Unaona? Akaniambia, nitakuoa on this day. Hakuna kitu itafanya. There's nothing that will stop me from marrying you. I mean, nilikuwa nasikia hapana, tusifanye hii kitu. Unaona?
Kamwambia, just go.
Nikamwambia tu, ama tuache tu kwanza. Akaniambia, hapana. I know we will beat this thing together. Unaona? I will not allow you to walk alone. I'll stand with you and tutafanya hii kitu pamoja na we will win together. Nikarudi home. Within that duration tulipewa, nilitaka niongee na Mungu. Unaona? Nikaenda tu with my, wakati my cousins walitoka home, nikafikiria, si ni disappear tu into an unknown place, niende maombi. Like, can I go and talk to God at some cool place?
Yeah.
Vile walitoka, wakaenda, wakaniacha home peke yangu. I remember it was on a Wednesday. Waliniacha peke yangu, nika decide, kwa nini nisitoke na niende? Sio Juda kwa kwake ameendelea na biashara zake ya Trongai.
Yes.
Mimi nilifunga mlango, nikachukua nguo zangu, nikatoka.
So, unaenda wapi?
Naenda tu mahali tu, katoka.
Were you intending to come back?
Yes, I was intending to come back.
You're just going to pray?
Yes, I'm going to pray. So nilikuwa nimesikia kitambo, there's a mountain in Ukambani, watu wenda maombi. It's known as Katoloni Prayer Center. Nikasema, sijaenda Ukambani, but wacha ni try this place. I just want to go, nikae tu peke yangu, in a bush or wherever, I just talk to God. Nikaenda. Sikuambia mtu kwenye nimeenda. I went, nikazima simu yangu. Jesse walinitafuta. Nikazima simu on Wednesday, on Thursday, on Friday, sitaki kuongea na mtu. I was alone. Unaona ile time unalia kama mtoto mdogo. You asking God, Mungu nikuserve for all this long. During my youth, mimi nimekuwa tu nikikuserve. In campus, mimi nimekuwa leader pale CU. Unaona? And this is my year, God, yenye mimi nataka kuolewa. And then this is what you're bringing to me. Mbona Mungu, unaona?
Because they didn't expect
me. They didn't expect me. Nikwambia, I can't.
Coming back not alive.
Mm-hmm.
Nikwambia. So Judy's there, your fiancé.
Actually, ndo aliningoja. Kanambia, ninakungoja, kuja. Nikaenda. And then, nikawambia, mimi kwenye nimekua, I've been speaking to my God. Na now, I am ready for treatment. Unajua nikuwa nimekata?
Yes.
Mpaka daktari na wapigia simu anaombia, please try, mwambie ni tuwa kujeda, mini nakata. How do you lose your hair, Jesse?
And your wedding is
and
coming.
And my wedding is coming.
And hair is the first thing and hair is the first bride you want to make sure unakapua.
Nikawambia sasa niko ready, tuendeni dawa. On Monday, at least tukakuwa na moment of thanksgiving, tukapigia pastor wetu wakakuja, we prayed together. And then life ikaendelea on Sunday, I didn't go to church. Monday ikafika, so wakanipeleka hospitali for chemo. Jisi mi nilifika chemo, nilifika usi, yu hospitali mi wenda, and then nikapata, what they do in the morning, huwa wanakuwa na hiyo a fellowship in the morning, because tulifika room 7, wakati wanagather together, all the workers wanakuwa na moment of prayer before they start the day. So wakikuwa pale wanaomba, they are singing, it is well with my soul. Because they used wanaimba, then they pray. Mi niko hapo, I'm the first patient kuingia. And then they're singing, it is well with my soul. Mi nilipiga nduru in the middle of the song. It is not well with my soul. Unaona? It is not well at all. Eh, wakajua huyu sasa, tutamhandle aje. Water side effect zinigonge, my friend. Eh? Jinsi nilikuwa ninasimama ninaenda chini. Because now I'm young, maybe they'll use the most strong drug. And then this is cancer stage 3. So they'll use maybe the strongest drug hapa. Jinsi siku moja niliamka nikafuta nywele hivi nikatoka nayo. A whole bunch of my hair like poof. Yote hivi. And then nikashika nikasikia, wait a minute. Yote imeenda. Nikajua kuisha mimi. I'm finished. Nikashika ingine kidogo. Nikakua, yote ikaenda. Hai, sasa hapa nikajua ni ukweli sasa hapa. Si kuzuri.
Mm-hmm.
Kafunga kitambaa, nikaenda kwa kinyozi, nikambia watu wa kinyozi, ni nyueni nywele. So wanashangaa, ai, mbona nywele yako yuko hivyo? Nikambia, msiniulize swali. I said, I need a shave. Wakanigonga yote. Katoa, and then nikafunga kitambaa. Kaenda home. So nikafanya the first session and the second session before my wedding.
Mm.
At the event of the wedding, Jesse, on 30th, I had no hair. Kabisa, I was so sick. Unaona?
When all this was happening before Tufiki hapo, where was Jude?
Jude. Tulikuwa tu na yeye.
Ana kusupport
kwa hivyo. Ana nisupport tu. Vitu zingine, the wedding ndo imekuja.
You still planning?
Yeah, we are still planning. Nikishindwa kwenda tao kutafuta vitu zingine, yeye anaenda.
Na alikuwa anajua umepoteza nywele.
Eh, alikuwa anajua nimepoteza. Eh, alikuwa anajua.
Nakwambia it's okay, still
it is married. Okay, we shall get married. Ananiona tu ninafifia day in day out. Anakuja kuniangalia. Every day angekuja kuniangalia at my cousin's house. Every day. Anakuja ananipata niko hapo, I can't eat. Sabia mouth salts. Kuna dawa unapewa unapata mouth salts. You can't even swallow anything. So Juda anakuja, ananipata, I can't eat. Watu wananiangalia hivi chakula iko hapo Jesse. Ninablendiwa mpaka food. Imagine Jude could come, Python is my fiancé, anani feed like a baby. Unaona? Anawambia wengine watu. I will marry you.
Our wedding is still coming.
Anani feed na mtu kama mtoto. Anawambia wengine, ununa vili unabembelezanga mtoto, kula mom, kula daddy, hivyo. Yeah. Ambia mami, kula. Si you eat, ndo tufanya harusi haraka. Si you eat, ndo pate nguvu tufanya wedding. Anani feed. sometimes hata ninashindwa kusimama, angekuja ananisaidia with everything, ana make sure nimeenda kulala na nimekula na nimeenda kulala, and then akiangechukua pikipiki anarudi kwake. Late at night at around 11 anarudi kwake. Hiyo usiku akifika ananiambia, umefika, lala vizuri, ni nini nitakuona asubuhi. Wedding ikafika, tukafanya wedding. I was weak. Nona, I was so weak, but we did it. Nah, it was the best wedding. Nona, because it was the day that we really, really waited for na imefika. So tukafanya harusi yetu, though it was a small one. Sa hizo tumeisha, Jesse, the money that my hubby and saved kwa harusi yetu, yote Jesse ilienda fu. Tulibaki 0-0. Nona, nothing.
Siku ya harusi.
Siku ya harusi.
Amekusupport, ndiyo hao nyinyi. Mumeenda church. Methodist Rongai.
No, we did it in Meru.
Meru?
Yes.
Methodist Meru.
Yeah.
So metoka Nairobi, mmeenda Meru?
Yeah.
Wewe ndiyo huyo umevaa gown.
Wow, yeah.
Siku ya harusi imefika.
Yes.
Ukoona ni reality.
Ni reality.
This
kapsa.
Man is still with
this
me.
This man is still with me.
Wow. You're blessed.
Amen.
He is truly a great man you have.
He is.
I've never had such a strong, but I think he's a strong. Because nilikuwa nashindwa. Yeah, and so many of you have been married. So I was wondering, he went on. So that's the harusi. Ukava gown.
Nikavaa gown.
Na ukateremka gown.
Na nikateremka tu gown. Kateremka.
Wakati mkuu unateremka hivi na gown yako, umesindikizwa na wazazi wako. Kamuona ndiye ule. Hako hapo mbele na suit. Ready to marry.
Unajua I was crying. Nilikuwa nalia.
Ukienda gown. And then, before sasa hiyo siku, did you at one point think he's just telling you, I'll marry you and marry you, but he'll change his mind?
No.
You knew he was serious.
Jude is a guy of his words.
So you knew he will actually marry.
I knew that.
He wasn't just encouraging.
He wasn't.
Hiyo siku ikafika, unateremka kwa aisle.
So me ninalia. Okay, I was emotional. Very, very emotional. And then people thought, maybe unaona vile tu bride ulialia, ati emotions, emotions. No, I was literally crying because I didn't know that God could favor me like this. No, like singe imagine, hii siku ndo hii imefika. Tukafanya wedding yetu vizuri, tukasema yes I do, tukaenda reception.
Na amekuangalia kwa
macho. Imagine ameniangalia hivi kwa saizo, ukiniangalia uso huku, niko pale, yani, nilikuwa tunaka funny. Nona.
Na kulikuwa na makeup.
Kulikuwa na makeup, but you see now with the effect of the drugs, hata ukipakwa makeup bado, kuna vile ngozi yako haikubali, inakuwa tu dry kabisa. Nona. So nilikuwa tu nakaa tu funny somehow. Makeup haiku blend vizuri na uso wangu. So nilikuwa tu nakaa tu funny, but
na bado
yeah, tu ndo alikuwa few people ndo alikuwa anaelewa what is happening, because hatukuwa tumeambia watu wengi. Mm-hmm. So only few people knew what I was going through. Mm-hmm. Na kwa nini niko hivyo. So tukafanya harusi, tukamaliza, and then tukaenda kupumzika hiyo usiku. Tunakuja honeymoon, lakini ile honeymoon tunakuja, tunaenda hospitali. Jesse, I don't know what is honeymoon. Mi sijui honeymoon ni nini. Na mpaka leo, mi feel like kuna gap. Kuna kitu, okay, my marriage is complete. But naonanga sikuenda honeymoon. Nona. And every time tukiongea na Jude mimi mwambia, "Oh, unajua hata huyu ujeni peleka honeymoon ile like jokingly tu naelewa mnacheka tu." Lakini tulitoka Meru on Monday, tukakuja, tukafika kwa hao. Jude alikuwa amejikakamua katoka in a small house yenye alikuwa anaishi, akaenda akarent a 2-bedroom house in Rongai. Now to start a family, lazima watu watatutembelea, we need at least a bigger house, tuanzie life hapo. Kwa hiyo nyumba Jesse ilikuwa na mitungi ya maji. Unaona? Jude alikuwa anaishi tu bachelor life yake tu. Unaona? Yeah. kitanda, anajisort kwa kitanda, anapika hapo kando, no, no, in a small bed sitter. So ameoa. At least he needs a big house. Kwa hiyo hawe yake ilikuwa na mitungi tatu ya maji. So si tumetoka Meru, tumekuja, Juda amenifungulia nyumba, ananiambia karibu my wife. Hapa mtungi. Sit down.
Mtungi ndio kiti.
Mtungi ndio kiti.
Did you feel at that moment like you've made a mistake? No. Like, this is not the man I'm supposed to be with?
No. Uh-huh. I didn't feel that.
How did you feel?
Tukaketi kwa mitungi. And then akaniambia, this is our home. Wow, okay. Nakumbuka, kesho, tunaenda hospitali for another session of chemotherapy. Now the third one. Kamuliza, what about honeymoon? Akanambia, situenda honeymoon hosi. Nikombia, apana, nataka tuende honeymoon mzuri. Kanambia, hakuna pesa. So you know, we don't have money. You are sick, you need treatment. Na hakuna pesa tuko nayo. Nona. So we relax too. Tukakalia mitungi. The following day on Thursday, was tuenda Monday, tukaka Tuesday and Wednesday. You know, watu wana expect tuko honeymoon. Mabishte wanatuona kwa barabara wako like, wait a minute, ah, see wako huku. Thursday nikaenda usi for another session of chemo. So mi niko pale ninaekwa dawa ya chemo. Then najua ukienda usi hata Judy's allowed to stay with me. Mwenye anakutekea care. So tuko hapo, Judy ananiuliza, unasikia aje hiyo swimo? Unaona, he's a funny guy naturally. Mm-hmm. Ananiuliza, mazi unasikia aje?
Encouraging you with this.
Encourage me. Unajua of course unacheka tu.
Yes.
Unaona. Lakini kwa moyo, there's heaviness. Mm-hmm. Unasikia tu ndani yako. Tukamaliza kwa dawa. So it's me, and to rudi home too. Tukarudi home, tukajikakamua kidogo. Asiju Judah alitoa pesa wapi. I think a friend of, no, vile tulienda church in Rongai, watu wakatupia present, wenye wakuweza kukuja Meru for wedding. No, na, tukapata pesa. Watu wakatugift, women fellowship, wanakuja na tobe karibu in the women fellowship, anatupatia bahasha, kumbe kwa na like 10,000. Men fellowship, wanakuja wanaambia Jude, hey, wewe sasa umekuwa mwanaume, karibu in the men fellowship, anampea bahasha, kumbe maybe kuna another 10,000 or more. Tukapewa ma presents, because there are so many people wenye wakuweza kukuja Meru for wedding. So the first Sunday nye tulienda church, they gifted us on that day. So tumepata pesa, nikambia Jude, kitu ya kwanza tununue kiti ban.
Tukalie mitungi,
tununue tu kiti please.
Akakwambia nini?
Kanambia ina shida. Tukaenda, tukanunua kiti, nice coach. Tukaanza tukakalia. Ah, it was
mitungi
fine.
Mitungi story, ikaisha.
Tukaanza ku... In fact...
Hata moyo ukatulia sasa.
Sasa inatulia jijesi na kemo ndo hiyo inakugonga, my friend. Nona, kemo inakumaliza kabisa. But finally, tukaweza kumove tu na life pole pole. Judah akarudi hasole yake. Ananiacha kwa nyumba, anaenda anapiga hasole kidogo, anapata kitu, tunarudi, tunakula. Hivo, tukaanza tu life hivo. Ushe kuwa ile sasa umasema, okay, mimi nimeolewa, I'm the wife and I'm sick. Nona, lazima ukue strong. Hii ni kitu haita toka jesi. Hata ulale kulia, uamkie kulia. This is the hard way, but the only way. Lazima, uipitie tu, iko tu hivo. By the way, Maina Kageni is my best radio presenter in 254. And there's something that Maina said on Sunday. It was featured in the Churchill, the series edition.
Yes.
And Maina said that you are strong until being strong is the only option you have. No, no. You are strong until being strong is the only available option you have then. Nikajiambia, by the big up Maina, you're my best radio presenter in 2-5. Wanapenda Maina, by the way, sana.
He's a cool guy.
Sana, he's a cool guy. Nice guy. I love Maina.
Yeah.
So, nikajiambia sasa, lazima nikuwe strong for myself and for Jude. Uyu jamaa amekuwa tu na mimi. Mbona nisimuonyeshe hata mimi, at least naweza kuwa strong. So, si sana, wacha tu nijaribu, at least nampikia. Ninangangana tu ninamuoshea tunguo, unaona. Sasa zingine nikiwezwa ninaachana, si anakuja anafanya yeye mwenyewe. Na life ikasonga like that. In May of 2018, nikafanywa the first surgery. The first surgery ilikuwa lumpectomy. Lumpectomy is whereby some part of the breast is removed. Hiyo yenye iko na lump hapo inachongwa hivi, inatolewa yote. Then inafunikwa with the mother fresh from different parts of your body. Inakatwa, maybe kama ni thigh or some other part yenye iko na fresh mingi, inafunika. So nikafanya the first surgery in May 2018. So hiyo ikaheal. Nikaka the whole month nikaheal. Just before, nilikuwa nimekuwa into drugs zenye azinge nifanya ni conceive. Nona, I was put on some serious drugs. Zenye, singe conceive. Nona.
With those drugs. Forget children.
Forget children. Not forgetting at unaweza pata, but after very long time, mm-hmm. after your drug imeisha kwa mwili. So I was put on drugs. To some extent, baka my menses disappeared. Nona. And I was okay. Tuka kubaliana na Jude. Jude akaniuliza, kama tutapata mtoto, it is okay. There are so many children outside there wenye wanahitaji love. Mm-hmm. Wenye wanahitaji kupendwa, washugulikiwe. A baby is a gift from God. Nona. Na Mungu akiona tu akubless na mtu yeye anakubless because it's a gift anyway. Yes. Na akiona how deserve, then anakuacha. Nona. So let's not nag God atupatie mtoto. Let us sign these documents na to agree on tutakaa tu sisi wawili. Nikamwambia, but Jude, you know nini, we need a baby. Akaniambia, stop. Kwanza your health comes first. And then let us forget about babies for now. Let us concentrate on your health first. Akaniambia, fine. So we signed those papers. Before you put into those drugs, you sign.
Unapeana consent.
Unapeana tu consent yako umekubali kutumia hiyo dawa.
And then we went ahead.
And then we went ahead. Imagine we are signing this consent even before we get married. Not only sign your consent since we're willing.
No, not when you're already getting married. It was way before.
It was way before. Because the doctor, you sit down.
So Jude is willing to marry you in the situation.
Yes.
Whether they get children or not, it's not his priority.
Yes. I come first.
He loves you so
he
much.
He does.
He loves you so much.
Jude does.
So did you took in the drugs and ukaendelea vizuri.
Unajua wanakuweka huku kwa ovaries. They suppress your ovaries somehow. Mpaka sasa hawezi pata periods kabisa. Without periods maybe hata hakuna mtoto somehow. So we were okay with that. Tumekaa tu. Just let me tell you the doings of the Lord. Just wait and see. Mi nimeenda mlimani on this day, Juda ameenda Meru. Nona. Nikaambia, God, thank you, God, umeniponya and everything. I got back to the same place I prayed. Nikaambia, God, aki God, thank you. But nikitoka mlimani Mungu, by the time I am getting home, God surprise me, do something for me.
Mm-hmm.
So mi nikatoka mlimani, nikaenda home, Juda katoka Meru, akakuja home. We met, how is Meru, nini nini. Nona, kwetu Meru kuna a lot of ngwashi, a lot of ndoma,
yeah, we are blessed.
Yeah, we are blessed in Meru. So Jude carried a lot of ndoma, a lot of ngwashi, akakuja nazo. So when he came, akakuja, usiku akachemsha for the breakfast in the morning. Kuja nayo, asubuhi so nitumia mko on Sunday. So we are ready to go to church together. Hey, mi vile niliamka nisikasikia, hiyo mgongo, It's pinning. Nasikia I'm sickish all over. then nikiangalia zile ndoma zenye amechemsha usiku, nikasikia nikikula naweza tapika hii staki. Mm-hmm. So I refused to take his breakfast. Nilisikia sitaki kabisa. Akaniambia basi, wacha mimi niende church, we baki. Maybe it's aftermath of you've been fasting for maybe some few days.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe it's you kuchoka. Relax kwanza, take some
little... You are fasting while you are still on...
I was on chemo. You know, when it comes to matters of God, kuna vile unajipanga tu. God anajua kukupanga hata yeye. Judah kaenda church. Mimi nikabaki home. Nikijaribu kusimama. I can't. I'm weak. Nikamtext, nikamwambia, mimi hapana. The way I'm feeling, I'm sick. Kaniambia hapo chini ufanyiwe test.
Mm-hmm.
Nikaenda, tulikuwa tunaishi karibu na Nairobi Women's Hospital. Nikaenda hapo, nikaambia daktari, I'm feeling this and this. Akaniambia, come here run a pregnancy test. Nikamwambia, hapana daktari, I can't be pregnant. Why? Are you married? Yes. Mbona tu si run a pregnancy test? And all the symptoms you're talking about ziko related to pregnancy. So can we run a test? Kwa sababu ame test malaria, all those other things are cool, na zote zinatoka negative. So nikamwambia, okay, ukiinsist, wewe fanya. But niko sure,
I can't be.
Yeah. Kaniuliza you on contraceptives, nabia no, but you fanya tu. Imagine akafanya, Jesse. The shock of lifetime. Jesse, I was expectant.
You are pregnant.
Yes. I am pregnant.
Unbelievable.
I am pregnant.
In the midst of chemo.
In the midst of chemo.
In the midst of being told. Yes. Don't expect to be pregnant because of this medication. You can't be pregnant. And here you are.
And here I am. Pregnant. Sasa, I don't know kama ni furahi. Unachanganyikiwa. Nikaanza kuuliza, God, ni nini hii? Why? Okay, tulembo tukipata mtoto, tusipate mtoto in the first place. But Mungu menpea mtoto. And then another thing comes into my mind. You asked for an extraordinary thing. And I am a God of extraordinary things. This is God. So when I went, in fact, sikuweza hata kuvuka barabara, niende, another nurse ndo alinishika mkono, because I was weak. I'm crying like a baby. I don't know nishukuru, I don't know nifanye nini. So, nikaenda home, nika text Jude. Jude is in church. Please come. Come now. Chida akakuja. Akachukua pikipiki akakuja. So when he came, nikamwonyesha hiyo karatasi niliandikiwa iko positive. And then he's like, what's this? Nikamwambia, I'm expecting. No, nikamwambia, we soma. Akasema, sioni kitu. Nikamwambia, soma vizuri. Haoni kitu. Nikamwambia, guess what? We will be parents. I'm carrying your baby. Wa Judah alishtuka. Ako like, what? What do you mean? Kutoka wapi? Lini? Aje?
I'm an Holy Spirit.
Nini? Expectant. For me? Ikombia, yes. How? Kanebe siamini. We should repeat if it was ako. Tuka repeat tena. It is positive. Ikombia, wait a minute. This is the God I serve. I asked for an extraordinary thing, and here it is. I'm expectant. And I know that this baby is God's. So tukapigia daktari. Mwambia, hi doc. Know what? Jackie is expectant. Katambia, this is impossible. Come tomorrow. So Monday asubuhi, yao sisi. Tulikuwa tunabebana. Yani, Judo angeenda kwa shop, niko na yeye. Yani, all over.
Yes.
Hata ange niacha. Nona. Tunatembea tu pole pole, tunatake walk. Mande tuko na Jude hospitali. Tuko kwa daktari.
Akafanya test.
Akafanya test mwenyewe.
Uh-huh.
Jesse iko positive.
Akasema.
Akasema, now that iko positive, and you're in the middle of treatment, you have two options. Number one, it is to terminate this pregnancy.
Why?
I'm in the middle of drugs. Baby and chemo, they can't marry.
Mm-hmm. Number two.
Number two, it is. You continue with pregnancy and stop drugs, chemo. Those are two options that you have
that
for now.
That means getting worse.
That means getting worse. Because if you opt to carry on with a baby, that means that it's even more worse. Because now cancer will not stop growing, or rather it will not stop spreading. Remember, it's in stage 3. And I'm expectant.
Mm-hmm.
So they gave us a week. Wakatumbeendeni nyumbani. Endeni mfikirie. Kama mnataka the baby or the other one. Tukienda nyumbani, mimi najiambia, come. There's nothing that will make me terminate this baby. Jisi liwe liwalo, sitatoa huyu mtoto. Aya, tukaenda home, tukaketi na Jude. Tukaambiana sasa, let us do what? Let us keep the baby. Daktari akapigia Jude, akamwingiza baridi.
Kambia, you decided to keep the
baby. Akamwambia, my friend, do you know what you are up to? You are up to losing your wife and losing your baby. So, you are the man. Make a firm decision. Let this baby be terminated. Furthermore, you will have many other babies. Nona. Hey, Judah kiingizo baridi, anakuja na baridi yake. Anakuja na mbia, no, my wife, please, please, let us allow to terminate this baby. Jesse nikasema, I can't. I stood firm. Nikasema, no, I will not.
Not my baby.
Not me. Let me try this, God.
Mm-hmm.
And that is why I actually came here to tell people, if you completely trust God, He will completely sort you out, Jesse. There's somebody out there who feels like the world is coming to the end. There is somebody out there who is in a situation and is in a verge of losing hope.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe you feel like, now, this is the last day I'm living. Inaweza kuwa si ugonjwa, inaweza kuwa ni situation jinsi imekugonga. People are going through stuff out here. Enda pale tu Kenyatta utembee tu uone what people are going through. I'm here as an advocate. I am representing God. And I am telling people that there is God in heaven. And there's a God who blessed me, a God who took me through this process. He still can take you through. Don't give up. Trust God again, even if it is another 1 minute. Trust God. Jesse, I chose to trust God and I chose to keep my baby. We went back again and told the doctors to may decide to keep our baby. So we decided.
What did he say about you deciding to keep the baby? What were the dangers of keeping the baby? Knowing that, yes, you're going to lose your life or the baby. What was there? Another the other option that doctor gave you, alikuambia ni nini umeamua utakuwa na mtoto, what were the chances of survival?
The chances of survival zilikuwa very minimal, considering the fact that now tumeacha ku arrest cancer cells.
So you stopped chemo now?
Yes.
To save your baby?
To save my baby. Waki stop chemo means kanza sasa zinaanza kusherekea. Hata hiyo dawa yenye imekwa zinaanza kuisherekea tu.
Yeah.
Nona. Nikasema, well, I'll die siku moja. Wacha tu nifanye nini? Nizae huyo mtoto. Unajua ni kwa nini Jessie I did that?
Mm-hmm.
The love for my husband. Imagine mtu ana risk kukuoa akijua uko na kansa. Alafu by a miracle of God, you're able to carry his baby. Kwa nini usi reciprocate this love? Umuonyeshe, ata mimi, I can give it to you. This is your blood. This is your baby. Nona. Wacha ata mimi muonyeshe the love I have for him by keeping this baby. If I die, let me die knowing I died for love. Nona. I died to save my baby and to make my husband feel that he is also appreciated and loved. Nona. I decided to dedicate this baby for him. Nimwambie tu, watu wengi walikwambia usinioe wakati walijua niko na kansa. Many people came to advise you, but you stood peke yako na ukanimari. And then God has blessed me with a child of your own. Mbona, I'll be very selfish, Jesse, nikitoa huyu mtoto wake. Nuna. At the end of the day, mimi nikufe. Nikikufa, hata hakuna kitu atabaki nayo. Wacha nimwachie mtoto basi. Nuna. Kansa ilikuwa imenisukuma vibaya. Nasema wacha tu nikufe. Nimwachie. Aone, people can die for love. And people can be so selfless for other people. Nona, me I chose no. Let me keep this baby for Jude. Nikaachana na chemo, nikaanza kwenda prenatal clinics. Kwenda the first month, the second, third, fourth, fifth. When I hit the fifth month, just you know now the body is ready for the baby. It's preparing for the baby. And so many changes in my body. It's just like the bump is coming up. Nona. Sasa saizo, cancer cells zimekuja tena. Nona, because my immunity sasa imeenda chini because of maybe the pregnancy, I don't know.
Yeah.
Ile surgery nilikuwa imefanywa, jinsi vile nilihit the fifth month, matiti ikabust, poof! Yote ikaenda nje. Ikapasuka, literally.
Pregnant.
Kupasuka. Jisi kafure ikafika almost here. And then like this. And I'm pregnant. Jisi nilikuwa nimeoza. My doctors can attest to this. And my husband can tell it. Nilikuwa nimeoza. Literally kunuka. Ungekuja kwangu ufungwe mlango. What ile itakuhit ni yo harufu yangu. Kuzi ninakaa kama kitu ilidedi kitambo. Hizi nyonyo imeoza kabisa inamwaga maji inatoa hizo nyama zikianguka uzaa hiyo yote. And just remember I'm expectant. Nikasema na mimi Mungu, okay. Saizo, Bob Kolimo, akaenda. Saizo, there's a senator, this is a senator man, the governor of a certain...
Wabomet.
Wabomet, na akaenda. Aki nikajua I'm next. But Mungu sunipe to some few months, please.
Nipate
mtoto niachie Jude tu alafu unichukue. Nona, I knew mi nitaenda tu roho safi. Kwa 5 months, nikaingia kwa daktari nikamuliza doc, can a 5 months old baby survive? Kaniambia hapana. At what age can a baby survive? Kaniambia ukifikisha at least 7 months, mtoto huyo anaweza survive. Nikasema na mimi, let me carry on. Just you chungu ya cancer, it's not something you can comprehend in your mind. Uchungu ambayo, hakuna dawa unaweza meza, ikutulize, hakuna. Uchungu inakushika mpaka una vibrate, literally hivi kuvibrate, uchungu. Let's say you are expectant. Nimeshikia tu matiti hivi. I used to walk like nimeva tu dila. Kwa natembea tu na dila kusimba at least nitashika hivi. Kidonda isishike. Nguo loose kabisa. At least kidonda isishike nguo. So hiyo niko 5 months. Nikangangana Jesse na nikafika 6. Na uchungu ambayo. Kufika 6 nikajua nitakufa sasa. Nikaona this is death. Wacha niende nikatole huyu mtoto sasa. Unajua I'm giving in kabisa, nimesarenda. Ile uchungu tunalala nayo na Jude tukilia usiku, nikaona hii itanimaliza. Tukaenda Kenyatta. Imagine tuenda kutoa mtoto.
Six months.
No, at least, unajua hizi pewa kimo ukikuwa na...
Pregnant.
Ukiwa pregnant. Kwenda Kenyatta, Jude akalipa pesa ya hiyo... Yo medical termination, yo abortion. Amelipa pesa. So just see, I'm here seated waiting for the doctor to call me and the next patient actually ameingia, ame prepare everything. Ndo nitolewe mtoto, see? And then my baby could kick me so hard. Ananiambia, mommy, please stop killing me. Mommy, please, what are you doing to me? Are you killing me? Nona. I would hear voices of a baby speaking to me. Na sasa jinsi daktari ameshaingia, ameprepare everything, ninaingia nitolewe huyo mtoto. Nilisimama na nikapenya na nikaenda. I left Jude akiwa amekaa. Nikamwambia, no Jude. Me, I'm hearing a voices of a baby telling me nisimuue. Mbona niue huyo mtoto? Na akitolewa tu atakufa, atarushwa hapo akufe. Nikakataa. Jude akaniambia, sawa, let's go home. Tukaenda home. Another time it happened like that. Mungu akanipea tu grace, nikafika 7 months. At least I rested. Nikaingia Kenyatta. Jinsi nikafanyiwa C-section. Nikafanyiwa cesarean, nikapata mtoi. On Valentine's last year, 2019, 14th of February, nikafanyiwa surgery, nikapata, niko na mtoto msichana. I named her Zawadi, because indeed ni zawadi kutoka kwa Mungu. Mtoto vile alikuja Jesse, ni preterm. Akajafikisha term bado.
Kako 7 months.
So ni aje ICU. Kalikuwa na a condition, daktari wanaita street distress syndrome or something.
Yeah, distress syndrome.
Distress syndrome. Kamtoto kamekuja ni kadogo, kanatosha na hii chupa, ni kadogo.
7 months, of
sana.
Course.
She was very tiny. Sasa nimefanyiwa surgery mchana. Then nikapewa dawa nilale juu ya the pain. Ujua it's a open wood, inakaa hivi. And then nawa nikuwa na surgery, nikafanyiwa surgery, mtoto akapelekwa kwa ICU na mimi nikaambiwa nilale. So when I woke up at around midnight, nikakumbuka, wait a minute, I have a baby. Nikamwambia daktari, lazima unionyeshe mtoto wangu. Show me my baby. Au mama wengine wako na watoto wao. Where is my baby? Akaniambia mtoto wako, ako wapi? Ako ICU. Nikamwambia utanipeleka nikamuone. Akaniambia sawa, twende nikupeleke. But remember niko na CS, huwezi hata tembea, ile uchungu nasikie umekatwa. Nilikuwa huko kwa ground floor na ICU, still kwa first floor something. Jesse, nilipanda kwa magoti. I want to see my baby. When daktari akanishika mkono, akatembea na mimi pole pole, akanipeleka ICU ya watoto. Jesse, when I saw my baby, hata afadhali singeenda kumuona. Zawadi was a very tiny thing. Amewekwa pipes all over. Kwa mdomo katoto kadogo kamefungwa pipe. Huku kamewekwa patches all over the body. Then ni kadogo. Kamefunikanishwa kanakaa katoto. Ana si katoto. You can't tell if it's a baby. So when I went to the ICU, come on, I screamed, daktari, this is not my baby. This is not my baby. I need to see my baby. Akaniambia, huyu ndio mtoto wako. Nikamwambia, unajua aje ni mtoto wangu? Nionyeshe ni mtoto wangu. Huyu si mtoto wangu. Mbona anakaa hivi? Mbona hata afungui macho? Unaona? Akaniambia, this is the label ya mtoto wako. Alikuwa amekwa jina yangu hapa. Lakini nikauliza Mungu, kwani Mungu, wachani tu na mimi? Mbona unanipea basi kitu inakaa hivi? It was so small. Afu nikagonjwa, kamekwa kwa machine. Mashindo kubwa kukaliko, kana breathe fast. Mi nikajua haki ya kata survive. Nikambia Mungu, we Mungu, afadhali unichukue mimi, usikachukue haka. Please, nichukue, I'm ready now. Take me home. But please, save my baby. Asikufe. Remember ni ICU. Jinsi watoto walikuwa wanakufa, unajua watoto, akiwa ICU wako tu kwa critical conditions.
Yeah.
Children could die at my watch. Mimi nikiona unaingia tu huko, unakutana na mama anapiga nduru, mtoto wake amepass. Lakini najua next ni zawadi. But I will tell God, we Mungu, aki usimuue tu, nichukue mimi tu, hata usifanye hata ni anything kwangu. Nichukue, usave tu zawadi. for Jude. Ninaenda, Zodi akakaa whole month. Na mimi sasa nikatoka Kenyatta because sasa mimi nishamaliza na prenatal things. So mimi nirudi sasa nikatreatiwe cancer. Unaona? So we had to leave the baby Kenyatta, twende home.
Uanze chemo.
Nianze chemo afresh tena. And the baby, remember, ako ICU.
Mm-hmm.
So tungekuja tu home. Juda nipeleka chemo. Tunasema, turudi tukaone Zawadi. Zawadi alika, I think, for a whole month, ajafungua macho. So tukakaa. Mi nikarudi chemo tena. I did like 2 cycles. Every day, remember, we are going to Kenyatta. Kila siku asubuhi, ili kwa Kenyatta, Kenyatta, Kenyatta. Tukaishiwa jinsi hata tuna job. Judah lost his job, I lost. Yani tumebaki tu hivo. Tuko tunadadia watu asubuhi wakienda job. Wenye wanatoka Runga kukuja inside za Kenyatta. Watupeleke, tuende na wao. Tunajua tutaingia saa 7 kuona mtoto. But we prefer tufike hapo asubuhi juu ya lift.
Mm-hmm.
Na huyu mtu akitoka job tena, atupick 5 tuende home. Because atuna fare ya kuenda every day. Mm-hmm. So tungeamka 4. Just remember niko na side effect za chemo. Juna naambia, my dear, wacha tu leo niende peke yangu. Naambia hapana, lazima nikupeleke. Sayo nina bleed, jesi damu zinamwagika like this. But I really want to go and see my babies alive. Tukaendelea, I think, for 3 weeks. And finally, finally, Jax, to climax it all, one day tulienda, Zawadi akafungua macho. Akatuangalia. All those times tukawa tunaenda, atuangali, kamefunikwa tu. Tuenda siku moja, tukapata, wow.
Kameamka,
na kamefungua macho, na kametolewa, tolewa pipes.
Na hakuna patches.
Na hakuna patches kwa mwili. And then nikakubwa kubwa kidogo. Hey, Jude told me, now this is the time. We are praying to the spirit of this baby.
Mm-hmm.
Anambia mshike mkono. Nikakashika mkono, akakashika. Sio tuko ICU. And then we would pray for her. Tunamwambia, wewe Zawadi, you must fight this battle. You must come out of this. We are speaking to your spirit. Na tunajua inasikia.
Mm-hmm.
You must fight this and we must meet at home. Sisi wote after this success. Mama ako amepigana yake, mimi ninapigana yangu.
Wewe
pigana yako Zawadi. And then akikangesikia tu kafanya miguu hivi. Unaona? Tukajua huyu.
Na ndio Zawadi unataka kuachia Jude.
Na ndio Zawadi nataka kupatia bwanangu. After 2 months stay. Every day tunaenda kumwangalia, every day tunaenda kumuona. After 2 months, Jesse, imagine we were released from the hospital with our baby.
Zawadi.
Hii siku tulienda tu, tumeambiwa, sasa mtoto wenu amepona. Ametolewa ICU, ameingia in the normal ward za watoto, incubator, ametoka kwa incubator, amepelekwa in a normal ward. And then this day tunaenda kumuona. Daktari atuambia, by the way, your baby is well. Mnaezaenda na yeye nyumbani. Akijisi misi kwa mini, I knelt kwa wodi ya watoto. Yani tuliomba tuna Jude, tukaambia, God, what a God are you? What I remember watoto wote wenye walikuwa kwa hiyo ICU. Jesse, they passed on, and Zawadi alibaki. Alibaki. Watoto wangekuja, wakona condition critical, wamekwa ICU. After some 2 days, unasikia mtoto alienda. Mtoto alienda. So, mimi nilikuwa naenda tu, nikifika ninachungulia tu like this. Nione kama kitanda ya mtoto wangu, imetolewa hizo nguo. Kwa sababu ukiona kitanda ya mtoto wako, imesha tolewa hizo nguo, meaning, amesha songa tu. Mimi ningeenda tu nifike tuko umbali nichungulie nikiona bado hiyo mashine inawaka nisema ti ninajua bado kako hai ninaenda ninakaangalia and this day comes
you're going home
we are going home
Zawadi
na Zawadi
na mko pamoja as a
family. Na tuko pamoja as a family.
Wow.
Yani we couldn't believe, tunaenda nyumbani. Tunaenda nyumbani, we went home. Remember now, I can't breastfeed. I'm on serious drugs, I can't breastfeed.
So unampea...
So nikampea the formula, your nan. Nikamfeed tu nayo, Saizo hatuna pesa. But people would come and support us. Let me tell you, jese mtu ni watu tu. Na usiishi peke yako, you can't do anything alone. Our friends, our people around you. People supported us. People really supported us. Churchmates, friends. Wangekuja tu watununulie maziwa ya mtoto, your formula. It was expensive though. Wana tu support tu nayo. Tukafindi mtoto, And today as we talk, Zawadi is a big girl. She's 1 year and almost 8 months as we talk.
Glory to the almighty Nona. God.
Zawadi is okay. I resumed my treatment. Currently, bado niko on chemo. And then, after this chemo, I'm into a surgery. Unaona? Lazima ningerudizo madawa tena. Nikazirudia.
Na ukaanza kupata sasa afya.
Nikaanza kupata afya. Nikaanza kukua mzuri tena. Our life ikaanza kuwa poa tena. We are happy. In the middle of the challenge, in the middle of this pain, Jesse bado sisi, we are a happy family. Let me tell you. Despite the fact that tuko na challenges because my husband is not working, na mimi bado, we are a happy family. Na tunashukuru Mungu. Therefore, I'm here to tell you, Jesse, cancer is for everyone. You can get it, I can get it. Anyone can get cancer. Even a 1-day-old baby can have cancer. And especially for ladies, it is, this is October. And as I said earlier, I don't know, if you walk to a hospital and you tell them you want to have your breast screened, I think they will not even charge you. Many hospitals are free. You can just get screened for free. Or even you can do your self-examination. If you feel a lump, then please run to the doctors. And not, don't wait until you feel a lump. Walk to the hospital early, because according to my doctor, Dr. Andrew Othiambo of Nairobi Radiotherapy and Cancer Center, he says that by the time you're feeling a lump in your breast, that shows that cancer has advanced. It is maybe in stage 3 or 4 by the time you're feeling a lump. Nona. So it is good for us ladies to go out there and get checked. Kama hata uski pain yoyote, cancer is a very ironic disease. In most cases, you'll find you've a lump and it's very painless. Painless kabisa. Ukienda hospital, unaambiwa it's cancer stage 4. Na haina hata uchungu. Nona. So it is the high time, ladies, we go out, get checked, get screened early. Kama kuna any disease, daktari, they have a way of telling. Kama kuna anything, wanaona. Na if it's early diagnosed, then chances are very high for you to be treated na ukwe upone kabisa. So this is, I'm creating awareness here. I'm speaking to ladies out there. Please go out, get to the hospital, healthy as you are, get checked, and then you will have
you'll
your...
You'll be fine, Jackie.
I will.
You will be okay.
Yeah.
You're fine now,
I am fine right now.
You only remained with one treatment. Yes. How many now?
Yeah, I've done 5 sessions, mm-hmm. which again is very, very expensive, Jesse, as I said.
And you're supposed to go for how many sessions?
I'm supposed to go for 6 sessions. Mm-hmm. I've got one remaining next Monday.
This coming Monday.
Okay. I'll be in for another session of chemo. Mm-hmm. Actually, sahi nikikuja nimepitia hospitali. Ndio nipewe dawa ya uchungu. Mm-hmm. The pain is so much. Very severe, Jesse. Kama sijapewa hiyo dawa, mm-hmm. singeza kukuja hapa nifanye tuongee na wewe, because it's very, very painful. So nimepitia hospitali, nikapewa dawa, then nikaweza kukuja hapa. I'm remaining with 1 session on Monday, which is very expensive. A session goes for 221,000, 1 session of chemotherapy. And then I got surgery, which is coming up.
So you need 221,000
yes.
By Monday.
The government of Kenya has a way, it has helped NHIF, who wanatulipia around 150,000. So you are left with, iyo pesa ingine, almost 72,000. So me and Jude, we are supposed to have 72,000 by Monday. Ndo tuende tufanye hiyo, tumalize, and then we start planning for surgery, which is, I think, at the close of this month or early next month. Hiyo tu ndo imebaki, and then life tu inasonga.
God is great.
Yeah.
All shall be well.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you to Jackie's husband, Jude, and the little baby, the angel, Zawadi. Karibu kwenye Jesse Junction.
Thank you very much.
I've heard the story so much from Jackie today. Mm-hmm. And let me tell you, wanaume kama wewe si wengi.
It's good.
You stand by a woman from that mpaka sai, you're one in a million.
Thank you.
I can attest he loves you so much, Jackie. Congratulations, my friend. Yes. And you have a very beautiful family.
Oh, thank you.
So this is baby Zawadi.
Yeah.
Kamelala sai, kamechoka sana. Ah, it's all right. Mm. So Jude,
yes.
Jackie has told me so much about her story and being a cancer warrior and so far, and you know, chemotherapy is so expensive. How have you been able to sustain your medical care, kulipia medical and you don't have a job yet?
In fact, Jesse, if I may say, that this is a very tough journey. That first of all, I acknowledge God. It's all about God, because if I may lie and say that maybe there is something that I can do to cater for medical bills, I may be lying. All I can say is it has taken the heart of God. And I'm telling you, it has been very tough. By the grace of God has been so sufficient. Releasing some of the money, sometimes even I don't even understand how sometimes we get those money, because, but as a matter of fact, it's a bit struggle. I'm telling you, it's a very big struggle that it is taking God to achieve some of the things. And I thank God, because we have good friends. Mm-hmm. We have people,
yes,
who most of the time are there for us. We go and send some people sometimes, and hustling, the little hustling now. What you call hustling, because if I sleep,
yes,
these people cannot be where they are, by you have to work.
Yes.
Despite to the situation, remember, Jesse, life does not give what you want. It is demanded. You demand life, it gives you what you want.
Yes.
And even if there is that kind of the situation, we have to work hard, struggle, and make and have what we need in life.
Have you ever been in a, have you ever, has the thought of giving up ever crossed your mind? Like, unasema, ah, Mungu, this is too much.
Most of the time, I think every human being under the spirit, when maybe you are moving and you feel now, you look aloud, you see that everything now imeumana kapisa. Venye ulikuwa unatarajia mambo itakuwa, imekuwa different. So you feel like, now I have to give up. But when I remember, it's not about me, it's because of somebody else, I feel like, you know, I should not give up. Unajipata tena sasa, unajiokota tena, you look forward. No, this life is about you decide what you want. You identify your route, where you want to get, and define your destiny. Then you work towards it. Because even if you get a lot of challenges allowed, with the help of God, you are going to tackle them. And you work towards it.
And you're doing this. You are doing this for Jackie. Like,
exactly.
Marrying her, you decided, I'm going to stand with you. So your life now, you decide, you dedicated it to helping
your love.
Jesse, one thing that I may say is that I came to realize that in this journey of salvation, the best service that you can do to God is by touching lives. You may achieve a lot in life. You may build big houses. You may have big machines. All those are good things. But touching one's life, you know, service is about loving people and helping people. Despite your suburb love, okay, I'm doing it because she's my wife, but also I'm doing it to God. I always tell people, when you touch life, you feel that there is something that you're doing. Whenever now I'm working to maybe to make these people comfortable, I may not be comfortable on my side, but when I see them smiling in the house, I feel, oh yes, God, this is what I want to see. You see?
And you feel so happy.
Feel so happy. And I glorify God because I say, this has happened because of you, God. It's not because of you.
Did you know that maybe God assigned you for that? Like, this is your assignment on earth?
Probably. Because I'm that kind of person that I don't ask you God questions. Huh? Why? I don't ask you why. Instead, I always say, what next?
Mm-hmm.
I ask you, God, what next now? This has happened. Okay. Now, give me wisdom. What should I do? Give me guidance. Yeah.
And now there are remaining some other surgeries to go, Jackie. There are chemos, two chemos.
Yeah. Actually, there are six, seven, and eight.
Six, seven, eight chemos. And one cost about 221,000. So you are talking of over 600,000 for just chemo.
Yeah.
And this one is new Moakabado. One is next Monday.
Yeah.
The other one, the other Monday.
Yeah.
And the other Monday. Mm. And Vado kuna surgery.
And we have a surgery. I'll actually have a surgery, a total mastectomy. Total mm-hmm. mastectomy is the complete removal of the breast.
Mm-hmm.
Kabisa ikato yote. Itolewe. This is a major surgery, Jesse, which Bado, we can't approximate how much it will cost us. Again, it's a big amount of money. So, Bado, we to God at the
God will see you through, Jackie.
We don't know how.
God has provided for people.
Sure.
He will do it for you.
Sure.
And I know there are people that are watching this show, and they love you too.
Yeah.
There are many Kenyans that are watching, and I know they love you people. When I came to visit you, I didn't know. I was just bringing a voucher that was given by a friend, Miss White Spa, to give to my fans. And you happened to be one of those fans and decided, watch an impair. I didn't know that this story would come up.
Yeah.
But I know beyond reasonable doubts. The same way you have people that support the show, people like Miss White, who tell me, Shika is impair, my fans. It is the same way. I know that there's somebody watching. And through the miraculous ways of God, you are going to go through it.
Yeah.
I know, and I know you're going to sail through. Actually, you don't need money. You need God.
Yes.
Yeah.
God is all you need to have all your needs met.
Mm.
And He's going to provide. And I know there's somebody else watching that will be touched and decide to do something for you. I'll tell you, don't expect human beings. Expect God. And He's going to do it for you.
Yeah, sure.
I know He's going to do it. I can feel it in my spirit.
Amen.
I can feel it in my spirit.
Amen.
That God is going to see you through.
Amen.
Ututacheka, we will not laugh again. Hamwezi kuwa mmetokata nyinyi meru yote mmekuja hapa, alafu hata watu wenu wasahau. I know people are going to come through for you.
Amen.
So far, God has brought you this far.
Sure.
He didn't bring you this far to abandon you. Okay,
That
is coming from my heart. But I want to say that. And Jude, the fact that you are the support system for Jackie with no job, God is going to give you a job. I know somebody is watching here that has. What have you done?
I've done procurement in purchase and resource management.
Procurement.
I graduated in 2016. Because of
you're a graduate.
Yes, Jesse.
You're a graduate of procurement.
Yes.
Paper, makaratasi
iko sawa. A bachelor's degree in procurement, in purchase and enterprise management.
Uh-huh.
And I've done a diploma in business administration.
Added. Mm-hmm. You added a diploma?
Yes.
Postgraduate diploma?
Yes.
He's qualified.
Mm-hmm.
Let's get Jude a job so he can support the family. And whoever is there that would like to support this family, please do so. Get in touch. Please, let's do so for this great family. You are blessed.
Thank you.
You are a happy family. Yeah. You've humbled me.
Thank you.
I don't know what to say, Jude, but all I can tell you is God is going to see you guys through.
Mm.
Okay? He's the same God yesterday, today,
and forever
he shall be.
Thank you, Jesse, for having us. It's a great, great honor. Asante sana. Asante sana. We are so, so grateful. And Jude and myself and Zawadi Amelala.
Zawadi Kamelala.
Zawadi is
beautiful,
so
girl. An angel.
She's very peaceful. Thank you, Jesse, for having us.
Anytime,
we
Jackie. We are going to walk through this together.
Yes. Mm. And one day we shall sit here to,
yes,
to just talk about how it went.
Yes.
You know, after the surgery,
yes,
and everything.
Amen.
Back.
Amen.
To let people know that God can be, because I'm 100% sure,
yes,
that God will walk me through things. I'll,
yes,
go through the surgery and I'll come out victorious.
Of course.
And I'll be back here.
Of course, my dear. Amen.
Yes.
You will. You will.
Sure.
God will do it for you.
Yes.
Yeah. So I wish you all the best.
Thank you.
I know God will come through for you.
Amen.
I can feel it in my spirit. So I wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And all of you, thank you so much for watching Jesse Junctions. Thank you for subscribing always to Jesse Junction. And I want to appeal to all of you. Please get in touch. I know you're sitting. Kwa Kazi, ya Jude. And Jackie's here that needs your help.